At this point, we've defined a bipartite graph and the notion of a matching. Now we're going to see the connection with maximum flow.
Intuitively, a maximum matching problem should feel like we're trying to push as much stuff from one side of the partition to the other. It should be no surprise, then, that there turns out to be an easy reduction to the maximum flow problem, which we've already studied. We build a flow network that has the same set of vertices, plus two more, which serve as the source and the sink. We then add edges from the source to one half the partition, and from the other half the partition to the sink. Internal edges are given a direction from the source side to the sink side. All capacities are set to 1. Setting the capacities of the new edges to 1 is important to ensure that flow from or to any vertex isn't more than 1. We only want to match each of these vertices once. Having constructed the graph, we run Ford-Fulkerson on it, and we return the edges with positive flows as the matching. Actually, all edges will have flows 0 or 1, as we'll see. The time analysis here is rather simple. Building the network is order E, or maybe order V, depending on the representation used. In any case, this is small, however, compared to the cost of running Ford-Fulkerson, which is E times V. Note that V is a bound on the total capacity of the flow, and hence a bound on the total number of iterations. In this particular case, this bound gives a better one than we would obtain either by the scaling algorithm or by Edmonds-Karp. Lastly, of course, we have the step of simply returning the edges with positive flows, and that's just a matter of writing the answer out, so that's order V. Clearly, Ford-Fulkerson is the dominant part, and we end up with an algorithm that is order E times V.